Hey guys, it's Flatpak Effects and I'm back with another tutorial. Now in this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to make this page turning effect of a magazine. Now if you're new to After Effects, this can be a little tricky at first, so I just recommend following along very slowly and eventually you'll get there. Now the first thing you'll need to do is import your images into After Effects. Now here I've just imported 6 images and I recommend at least importing 6 just so you can follow along with what I'm doing. Next we're going to right click and create a new composition. Now this composition I'm just going to call book just so we know what we're working with here. And I'm going to label this one HD 1080x25, make sure the duration's at least a minute in length. Okay, next we want to create our pages. So I'm also going to right click and create a new composition. I'm going to call this one page 1. Now it's very important for this that I'm going to set my width to be 960 by 1080. So that's half the width of full HD and I'm going to hit OK. And this is what we should have. Next I'm going to take that composition and I'm just going to duplicate it until I end up with 6 pages. So I can double click and open up all these pages so they're ready for our images. And I'm going to go back to page 1 and drag in my first image. Now, obviously you can drag in your own image here. And then all you need to do is just resize it so that it fills the entire frame. Obviously your images will be a different aspect to what mine are here. So you'll just need to reframe them and move them around so that they fill the entire screen. So I'm just going to quickly go through here and just resize all my images so I end up with all my pages full. Okay, now I've just gone through and added all my images like I did in the first one. So all my pages now have images in them. Okay, next we're going to come back to our main book composition here and we can start to add the pages into our composition. So I'm going to start with my back page 6 here and I'm just going to resize this and reposition to something like this. So that's my last page, which is page number 6. Now the ordering is really important and it can become a little bit complicated to get your head around. So it will help if you've obviously followed along exactly by numbering these so you can see the number order that I'm using. So next we're going to jump to page number 4 and we're going to drop this in over page 6. Now all I need to do here is if I navigate down to the transform properties of page 6, I can copy these and paste them onto page 4, so it sits directly over the top of my page 6. Now next, I'm going to grab my page 5 layer and drag that under page 6. And I'm going to turn this off so we can't see this. Now this is a little bit confusing about the way that we've ordered these, but it's very important. And you'll see why in the next step when I add the page turn effect to this page number 4, which is our first page. So I'm going to select page 4, come up to effect, down to distort, and this is what we want here, this CC page turn. Okay, now you can already see it's already added this page turn effect to our layer, but we obviously need to adjust a few things here to make it work. Okay, here I'm going to navigate down to the effects control to reveal the CC page turn, and I'm going to move across so that our playhead is at the 10 frame mark. I'm using the time code here to line up with exactly on the 10 frame. And I want to create a keyframe for the fold position. I'm going to move across to 13 frames and create a keyframe for the fold radius. And I'm going to drag this all the way to the lowest point, which is 4 in this instance. Then I'm going to move across to 19 frames and create another 2 keyframes for each of my fold radius and fold positions. I'm going to change the fold radius to 150. Then I'm going to come across to 1 second and 7 frames, create another 2 keyframes and drag this one back down to the lowest point, which is 4. Also just going to make these easy ease in. And that's it for that one. Now for the fold position, we need to animate this. You'll see when I click on fold position, we get this little icon here. And that allows me to grab the end of the page here and drag it down. So I want to drag it down so that it's fully closed in this bottom right hand corner. I'm then going to come back to my first keyframe on the fold position. And I want to drag this to the opposite side so that my page lines up naturally with the center line and my little icon here lines up with that bottom left-hand corner. Then I'm going to move across to the middle section here and I'm going to move this to somewhere just around this sort of position here, just sort of midway through. Now, if I actually just play through that, you can see we've already created the page turning effect. So that looks pretty good there already. Now, this is where it gets a little bit tricky because you have to start thinking not just of the page you're working on, but two pages ahead. So by that, I mean that at the moment, on the back side of this page, we're seeing the same image. So it's appearing the same image on the front and the back of this page. And we want this page to be different from when the page flips over. So this is why we put this page number 5 down here. And we're also just going to rename this one just to keep track of page 5 blank. Then I'm going to come back to my page 4 layer. Under the back page settings, we want to change this to be page 5 blank. And you can see it automatically displays our page 5 image. I'm also going to turn up the opacity. So that's probably the most difficult part to get your head around in this effect. So once you can master that, you can just keep adding more and more pages to your composition. Now we have to add in the next page. So as this page turns, we want to reveal page 3. So to do this, we're going to drag our page 3 onto the bottom this time. Again, we're going to turn it off, and we're going to also call this one blank. Now, in order to reveal page 3, we actually want to place page 2 and do the same flip effect. So this time, we want to place it under page 6. And what we're going to do here is grab the transform properties of page 6. So I'm going to copy those onto page 2. So now page 2 sits behind page 6. Now, the reason we put page 2 under page 6 is if I put it on top of page 6, you can see that we've changed the image order. So we need to put it under page 6 because we don't want it to affect or hide our back page. Now, this will become more clear in a second, but first we're going to need to grab page 4, grab the CC page turn, copy those properties onto our page 2 and just paste them in. That's going to reveal the page turn there. And what I want to do here is I want to navigate over to 207 and highlight and move all those keyframes back there. And for page 2, we're going to come up to the effect control and change this to be our page 3 blank. So at the moment, you can see we've got page 6, page 5. As page 5 turns, it reveals page 4, which is also revealed page 3. Now, if we leave page 2 where it is, you can see that as it turns, because it's under our page 4 animation, it's going to animate behind that layer. So we won't actually see the page turning on top. So what we need to do is line our playhead up with the end of page 4's transition here and split this layer and move the last part of page 2 above page 4. You can delete these ones down here, these keyframes, and these keyframes would have been duplicated up here now. So you can see as the page turns, it'll appear on top. Then all we need to do is we just want to reveal our last page, which is page 1, and we're going to put that under page 2, drag the start of that to here. I'm just going to navigate down, copy the transform properties of one of these other pages, paste that onto my page 1. But for page 1, because it's the last page, I'm going to off-center it to the left this time. So if we just play through that, you can see what we have here. All of our pages are turning in the correct way, and they're revealing the correct pages in their order. Now, it is a little bit complicated to get your head around that, and it will really help you if you number your pages in the same order that I have so that you can follow along with the page numbers. The best way to think about it is to hold a piece of paper in front of you and write a number on each side of the piece of paper, so 1 and 2, and as you turn that page, you're revealing that new number. So if you physically turn a page of a magazine or a book, it'll help you get your head around what is on top and what should be revealed on the other side. So eventually you'll end up with the even page numbers lined up and then the odd page numbers in between. Okay, so the last thing we can do here is we can add a back to our actual book. So I'm going to create a new layer, a new solid. I'm just going to call this one back, and I'm just going to make this color a light gray, and I'm going to drag this just down to the bottom of my layers and then just reposition it. to something like that. The other thing I can do here, if I grab my pen tool, I can also create some little edges here on my book just to help give it a bit more of a magazine or a book appearance. Now, the other thing that some of you may have picked up is that the images actually invert on the opposite side. So for instance, if I look at page 3 here, you can see that she's positioned on the left. But when I actually go to my page 3, you can see she's positioned on the right. Now you can just pre-flip this layer by selecting a layer coming up to transform and then just flip horizontal, and now it'll be displayed in the correct way on your book. So if that is an issue for you, then you can go through and just do that to the pages that appear inverted. Now the good thing about this is we built our magazine all within this one composition. So what we can do is we can take that book composition, just right click and just say new comp from selection. And now we have the ability to rescale this book and add in a background or add it over the top of whatever you would like. So in this case, I'm just going to create a new solid, drag this behind my book layer. I'm going to come up to effect, down to generate, and just add this gradient ramp effect. And I'm just going to select my first layer and just make it a sort of dark gray, almost a black. And I'm going to change my second color to be almost a black here. And the first start ramp, I'm just going to bring this in just to give a little bit of an edge and just drag this scatter ramp up. Might even just lighten this up slightly just to give it a nice background. And the other thing I just added here was a light leak that I got from the Flatpak Effects Vintage Light Leak Pack and just added that over the top for effect. Then all you need to do is the last thing you can do here is grab your book layer, just hit S on the keyboard and just create a little small scale, and that's it. So there you go. There's a really effective way that you can showcase your images or work in a professional way to people. And the only tricky part about it is really just getting your head around that ordering. Now, to add more images in, all you have to do is just go back to your project, duplicate more pages, and then just keep adding the pages onto the bottom in the same way that we've been doing these pages, and then keep adding in and duplicating the CC page turn effect onto every second page, and eventually you can create a whole book. Now the other thing you can easily do is come over to one of your page compositions, just add text over one of the images, go back to your book layer, and you can see the text is automatically added to that page. So there you go, guys. That's how easy this effect is to make inside of After Effects. If you found this tutorial useful, please like and subscribe. Thanks very much for watching. And remember, Flatpak Effects is the Flatpak anyone can build.